Historically, Bolgatanga lies on the southern terminus of the ancient Trans-Saharan trade route. Today, Bolgatanga is the capital of the Upper East region. It's the largest producer of leatherworks, smocks, and straw baskets in the region. In fact, it's the art and craft center of the Upper East region. This place also boasts of very sumptuous traditional meals. And this is reason enough for me to visit this place. I'm in Bolgatanga, capital of the Upper East region of Ghana. It's the Onga Foot Tour and is brought to you by Onga, my myself in hand, Ilele.
So, the reactions are,
Yes, people are really loving it. So, what do you think? It's the same reaction everywhere. It's official. The food revolution is here. Cooks and households everywhere are scrambling for Onga shrimp cubes.
Are you there?
Onga, mama's helping hand.
Onga, eye adi papa ma obia. Nti ube nye diani a if you say we use Onga. Jese Onga ni eye de.
I realize that my food is special, and that special thing is Onga. So Onga is a magic.
Nti mi pese min chire aman for se. Obia onye diani a on use Onga na Onga ya adi papa ma obia.
Onga, elele.
Alright, so again, you're welcome back. It's the Onga Foot Tour, and today I'm in Bolgatanga. This is the capital of the Upper East region, in the northern part of Ghana. You know, I've really toured the whole country, and I'm so glad to be in, you know, all three northern regions of Ghana. They have so much to offer us as far as, you know, traditional cuisine is concerned. Alright, my guest is, well, okay, she doubles as, you know, our host and our guest, because she's hosting us here in Bolgatanga, and then she's also our guest on the Onga Foot Tour. Auntie Lamisi, what kind of a name is Lamisi? Where are you from?
I'm a Franfra, and I'm born on Thursday.
So that would be in Akan. All right, so Thursday, Lamisi. Yeah. So the male Thursday born would be?
We don't have a name for.
Okay, so is it unisex? Can we call a male, you know, born on Thursday, Lamisi?
No.
Oh, okay. I would have loved to call one girl Lamisi. All right, okay. So, here in Bolgatanga, what are you preparing for us?
Yeah, I want to prepare a meal we call Gaari.
Gaari?
Yeah, but it's popularly known as Tumbaani.
Okay.
It is well known in across the three northern regions.
As Tumbaani?
Yeah, yes, but yes. We call it Gaari.
Gaari. When you say we call it, who?
We, the Frafra.
Oh, you're Frafra.
Yeah.
Okay.
The Greenie speaking.
Uh-huh.
We call it Gaari.
Gaari.
Yeah.
All right, so Tumbaani, also known as Gaari.
Yeah.
Yes, I got it. All right, so what do we eat the Tumbaani with?
Blended dry pepper.
Okay, so just like
salt.
Your powdered pepper, yes.
Yeah, powdered pepper, yeah. And salt, mixed with salt.
Oh, I see. Yeah, so the salt here.
Yeah, the salt, it tastes very good.
I see.
Then we have shea butter.
Oh my goodness, of course there will be shea butter here.
Yeah.
You know, they have a lot of shea nut trees.
Exactly.
I mean, I keep talking about the vegetation of this place. The fact that it's mainly grassland, you know, but it's also interspersed with Guinea savanna woodland, and you have, you know, a lot of drought resistant trees here. You have trees like the baobab, like the dawadawa, like the acacia, and then of course there's the shea nut tree. Okay, I said drought resistant because the weather here is just incredibly hot. So, you know, all of these trees can withstand the drought. All right.
We are going to start with...
Okay. So, this is bean flour.
Bean flour.
This is bean flour. Yeah. What kind of beans? Is it red beans or the normal white?
You know, the normal white. The one
okay. It's your black-eyed bean. Black yes, eyes. Beans. Okay. So, we're just pouring some water into our bean flour. How much water, you know, is enough? Yeah. Like, you know, a lot of us are going to try this for the first time.
This... Mm-hmm. We didn't measure the distance.
Yes.
The flat.
Yes. So you have been doing this for years.
So I
keep saying that, you know, in Ghana, in our kitchens, we don't do a pinch of salt,
a
pint of water, and it's rule of thumb. Yeah. You know what you're doing. You know just how much is enough by looking at it.
It takes experience,
you know, years of experience to know.
Yeah.
All right.
Because your hands will be in it when you get the texture.
Okay. So you know the texture you're looking for.
Okay.
I'm itching to know the meaning of the name Bolgatanga.
Bolga.
You know, some people say Bolgatanga.
It's Bole.
Bole.
Tanga.
Bole Tanga. Okay, what does that mean?
So the Bole is the mud we use.
For your mud houses. So you know their architectural style is still very, you know, like local, indigenous, ancient. Yes. Uh-huh, let me say that. Ancient. And they use mud houses. You know, the houses are made, you know, of mud. You know, in fact,
so the finishing of the house, we use something we call bole.
Bole.
That one is to tile.
So the bole is the mat.
Smoothen,
okay.
That's the one we use to smoothen.
Yes. I know it makes your rooms very cool.
Yeah.
Yes, I know that.
It's like clay.
Yeah. Yes. And then the tanga would be what?
The rocks. You can see that.
Oh, of course. There are so many rocks. The rock formation in this land is just beautiful. You find rocks that actually jut out of the earth, you know, and they come very well molded. I mean, I just look. This is one place I've been, and I'm just, you know, in awe of God and His power. Okay, that's why it's Bole Tanga. And then over the years, you know, we've corrupted it and we call it Bole Tanga. But Bole for the mud, you know, which they use for their houses here, and Tanga for the rocks, you know, that are characteristic of this place, the Upper East region. Bolgatanga, Bole Tanga. I like that. All right, so what festivals do you celebrate here in Bole Tanga?
We celebrate the
Ada Choir
Festival.
Ada Choir Festival, what's that about?
Maybe that one we do it after harvest. It's just to thank God for a good yield.
So farming season and then after, okay.
We call that one Ada Choir.
Ada Choir. Okay, I just want to know about, say, your dances and your music, you know, folk songs. You know, do you have any
a cool music, don't try me.
Okay, so do you have any Fafa cool music?
Yeah, so from the Fafa side, I go for gospel.
Gospel.
Our gospel.
Can you sing any of, you have nice gospel? Yes, do. Please do. Let your pastor be proud of you. I intentionally didn't tell you. I wanted to spring it up on you.
So let me tell you something.
She's now dodging me. Okay, now.
I'm not dodging you, but let me tell you.
All right.
The next process. Okay. I'll finish making this.
Okay. So we finished. Okay, she's done mixing the bean flour with water.
Not water. I finished mixing it.
Yes, the bean flour with water. Now you're going to add some
salt.
Some saltpeter.
Yeah.
So that's saltpeter juice.
Yeah.
Okay, you know, I've also observed what they do here with the saltpeter. You know, from what I've seen in several editions of the Onga Foot Tour, some of episodes of the Onga Foot Tour, you know, I've seen the people will just drop a rock, you know, a piece of the saltpeter in their food, in their beans, for instance, if they're cooking. But here, they leave in water. You know, so they want that solution. They leave in water and then it washes into the water and then they use the juice, you know, or maybe, I don't know, maybe we can say the stock, but they use the juice of the saltpeter. You know what I mean? Okay. Because I'm told you want to avoid all the sand particles that are in the saltpeter.
Exactly.
Yes.
Exactly.
So that's one thing you can also learn, even if you're not from the Upper East region. So we're in Bole Tanga, because that's the original name, Bole Tanga. We're in the capital of the Upper East region, and that's where Auntie Lamisi is preparing Tumbaani or Gaari.
When I lose the water,
yes,
the color was white.
Yes.
Now with
but now the color has changed. Saltpeter does that. This was, you know, like creamy. but you know, as in the color, but it's now, you know,
and
a shade like a light brown shade.
You know, some people when they take beans, they say, oh, my tummy is
they have gas
issues, so the salt
I didn't know that. Okay, so you don't feel bloated
and have, and you know, have yes.
All right, okay. All right, so that's another reason why we use the salt pizza. I also know it makes the bean, you know, cook yeah, faster. I want us to take a closer look at how you know, fetch your,
we are going to fetch this,
yes,
mold
the bean mixture in, you know, into the leaf. See how she does that. So there's no salt in this.
No.
Wow. No salt in this, in the gari or tumbaani.
Some add salt.
Some
but
add salt.
I don't want salt because the salt, sometimes you are not able to know those who are going to take the milk.
Right. Since the pepper we're going to have with the tumbaani has salt, we would rather not use salt. Besides, we don't have to take too much salt anyway.
Exactly.
Yes, we don't have to take too much salt. So I'm still waiting for that song in Frafra. You know, I just want to get the language, you know, learn, you know, as much as I can before I leave.
I'm going to sing Akanyange, Satan Akanyange.
Before then, what
before
are you,
then, why I want you to put them? Water under the pot.
Before you put the leaves?
Yeah.
All right, so before you line the bottom of your korogo donga, let me just do the
doko,
which is your daddy saying, your metal pot.
Yeah.
You know, you fetch in a bit of water, just a little water. Uh-huh. What's the water supposed to do? Why do you do that?
The water will help.
Okay, we need the vapor because this is like a pudding.
Thank
you. So we're steaming. Yes. So the method of cooking here is steaming. And this is like your bean pudding.
Yeah.
Yes. Your gari or your tumbaani, you know, it's a bean pudding. Is there fire under the pot?
No fire yet.
Oh, okay.
If you put the fire early, it will start boiling.
Okay.
Once
and
you have
some of it
will
be cooked and others will be not cooked. That's why. So of course, that's why.
That's the reason why you need to finish the molding.
Okay.
So you have everything done at the same time.
All right. Okay. So let's do that.
Yeah.
All right. So a little water in your doko, in your dadesang or your metal pot.
Yeah.
And then you line the base of the pot with some leaves. Yeah. Remember, the method of cooking here is steaming.
Yeah.
So we're using just a little water because all we need is the vapor, you know, to cook the gari or the tumbaani. And now I want to hear that gospel song in Frafra. Let's go.
Abolato, bolika, abolato, mame, wontenga, my table to mommy. You won't. I will laugh to mommy.
What was the meaning?
It's like God is with us.
So strong.
Morning, afternoon,
all day,
and
long
evening. So the devil have no way
indeed
to stop us.
That's powerful.
Anything.
Yes. All right. So you see how we fetch our tumbaani, you know, into the cola leaves. You know,
and you have
and
to
put
wet
on
it.
And you have to, of course, the leaves are in water.
Yeah,
you have to wet it.
You need to wet
it
because when it's cooked, you remove it from the leaves.
And
so
it's easy to remove.
Thank
okay,
you.
Yeah. Thank All right, so it's the Onga Food Tour, and we're in the capital of the Upper East Region of Ghana, Bolgatanga, where Aunt Lamisi is preparing gari, you know, or known elsewhere as tumbaani. We're gonna have this, you know, with a special sauce. All right, so Onga Fatua, Mashi by Onga, Mama's helping hands, Ilele.
Ilele.
Mommy, can I help?
Can I also help? What is this?
It's Onga.
What does it do?
It's the key to delicious food.
Onga gives any dish such a great taste and unique flavor that every meal is a special treat.
Mm. Can I help?
Always when the food is ready.
Onga, Mama's helping hand. And now, introducing the 50-gram sachet, which gives you more.
Ani dia tono munyina ejofuo bebia de omuwo munto Onga ango ye papapa uji ye duani eye de pa mo dia nkasa tani dia e oho okro oho de eye Onga Green soup woho, eye onga. Okra soup woho, eye onga. Akwamfe woho, eye onga. Nanchunam woho, eye onga. Mpacho, obia to onga. Onga ye papa mo obia.
Welcome back, Onga Photo from Bolgatanga, capital of the Upper East Region. Auntie Lamisi is preparing Gaari or Tumbaani. So we've put that on fire now. You saw how she molded that. It doesn't take too long to cook. Remember, this is steaming, and so we're going to retain all the nutrients. I love this, you know, this Tumbaani. All right, so let's see what sauce we're going to do here. So what do you call the stew in Fafa?
Kanzere.
Kanzere. Okay, so let's see that. Okay, so... So you're going to use the shea oil, is that what you're going to use?
Yes, it's there.
Alright, so melted shea butter, but you're putting on fire again. Yeah. So originally, this is how you eat your Tumbaani or your Gaari with. You know, with just shea butter, you know, oil, you know, it's shea oil, and some powdered pepper and salt. That's it. Amazing.
I would like to use some guinea fowl.
Oh, of course! We cannot cook any soup or stew or whatever sauce in the Upper East region of Ghana and not have guinea fowl. They breed a lot of guinea fowls here.
Yeah, so I don't want it to be deeply fried and dried.
Yes.
So I'm going to.
Just like I like it. Very, you know, juicy. And
yeah.
Listen. I didn't want to do this, but I am so tempted to. I just want to, you season this with your Onga seasoning?
Yes.
What Onga seasoning did you use?
I used Onga Classic.
Okay, so she used the Onga Classic, yes, to season her guinea fowl. So she just wants to fry, you know, the guinea fowl a bit, just briefly. Oh, this is so well seasoned.
So this fire is hotter and I want
to... Okay, so you want to swap. Okay, let's do that. Okay.
Okay, I'll bring this down.
Alright, okay.
I don't want to bring this down because this one doesn't want to delay at all.
Yes.
So it goes straight.
Remember not to change the temperature of your Tumbaani. Yeah. Alright, so we're just frying guinea fowl. This is steamed. And I just love how you season this with your Onga Classic. What do you do?
I'm a traditional caterer.
You specialize in traditional cuisine.
Traditional cuisine.
I like that.
And I like doing more traditional
meals. Maybe I can also call...
Than continental.
Continental. Okay. That's nice.
So I'm going to take this out now.
Okay.
Because I don't like...
All right. So we don't want this to be too dry. We still want it juicy.
Yeah.
I like that. You know, we still want it juicy. So, all right. So... We were done, you know, frying our guinea fowl. Our oil is also still very hot. So what are we going to put in now? Okay. And then of course some chopped onions. Remember, you know, we have modernized the sauce, the pepper sauce they used to eat Tumbaani. Alright, so that's just some ground pepper. So our ground tomatoes also go in here, and then that's it. Yes. All right, so that's it. So, and then of course, I know you are about to use your Onga seasoning.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. So, which one are you going to use?
With the Onga, I will use Onga stew.
Okay, of course.
Then I will
use one shrimp tablet. Okay. Yeah, that's a shrimp powder. You want the powder instead? The powder. Okay. All right. So, one stew, Onga stew. And then one shrimp powder. Okay. See, oh my goodness. You have been doing this for long, you know.
It's easy to.
Of course, the sachets are very easy,
very
to, open.
Easy to open.
You know, you don't have to put it in your mouth and bite it. And
I don't want to have a very dry stew.
Yes.
Everything have to. Keep on going.
Okay.
So that by the time you put everything, you get this, not too dry.
Not too dry.
Yeah.
So,
I'm putting my Onga.
All right. Okay. So that's the Onga. We're gonna have the stock of the guinea fowl. Of course, she's a traditional caterer, so she knows her stuff. She knows her catering. I love that. And remember, we don't want our stew to be too dry. Okay. And this again is a very simple meal. You know, this is. What I love about the traditional cuisine here, in fact, in all three northern regions of Ghana. Meals don't keep too long on fire. They don't kill the nutrients. You know what I mean? The meals stay nutritious. And that's why they're such a healthy bunch. Look at Auntie Lamisi. She's just enough confirmation, isn't she? All right, so how do you know if it's cooked? It's going to get tough, that's all.
Yeah, let's it will get tougher. Yes. You know, at this stage, it's always good to put some of the leaves on top.
Oh, you see, after you put in the tumbaani, you cover it again with another leaf or some more leaves. Yeah. Because you want to trap as much vapor as possible.
Exactly, yeah. And the water is very small.
Yes, because we're using very, very minimal water. Okay. And so that's it. This is so easy. As for the stew, I'll leave you. You can do it any way you know you want because we have our different ways of preparing our stews. Oh, thank you, Auntie Lamisi. It's Onga Fatawa in Bolgatanga, capital of the Upper East Region of Ghana. Auntie Lamisi is preparing tumbaani or Gaari, you know, with our guinea fowl stew. And how do we say guinea fowl in Frafra?
Kongo.
There's a dance called Kongo. I don't know if people know it. All right, with our Kongo, Kongo, Sada, Elia Sada, guinea fowl. All right, Onga Photo brought to you by Onga, Mama's Helping Hand, Ilele.
Ilele.
So, the reactions are,
Yes, yes, people are really loving it. So, what do you think? It's the same reaction everywhere. It's official. The food revolution is here. Cooks and households everywhere are scrambling for Onga shrimp cubes.
Are you there?
Onga, Mama's Helping Hand.
Tumbaani or Gaari is ready. Remember, we're having this with guinea fowl stew. However, Auntie Lamisi also prepared, you know, the original pepper sauce that we eat this with. So you have your powdered pepper and a bit of salt in it, and then you know some shea butter which we fried with some onions. So you know, those of us who are not used to the shea oil, the shea butter and all, would go with the guinea fowl stew. And you know, gradually we'll get used to the shea butter, yeah? Okay. And I'm joined by Aunt Mercy. I told you our family in all, you know, three northern regions of Ghana. Yes, Aunt Mercy is from here. You know, she lives here in Bolgatanga and she's my cousin's wife. So my cousin's wife, that would make her my cousin-in-law, sister-in-law. Okay, maybe sister-in-law. All right, Aunt Mercy, you're welcome. Aunt Lamisi has been so gracious, you know, and warm and pleasant to us, you know, here in Bolgatanga. She's prepared Gaari or tumbaani, and then of course you've seen the two sauces. We have the pepper sauce, you know, with our shea butter, and then there's the guinea fowl sauce. Of course, you know where I will go first. I'll first go for the guinea fowl, and then you know later go for the shea butter. All right, so please serve us until I sit down. So actually, they also attend the same church. So, small world, isn't it?
Yeah, very small.
Okay, for me. Okay, for Auntie Mercy, too. For me, one. Because, but for me, one, and then guinea fowl, two.
So, you say you go.
Of course, I'll go with the guinea first, the Sada. Of course, you know, we have nicknamed guinea fowl Sada on the Onga Photo. Maybe some people won't find it amusing, so let's just go with the frafra name, which is the Kongo. Kongo. All right, okay, that's okay. Thank you so much. Thank you. Maybe Aunt Mercy will just have to use her hand, or you want to cut it first and then use your. Oh, you can?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Now she's teaching us how they eat it here. I like that. I didn't think that was possible. Okay, it's a table knife, so it's not as sharp as you know your kitchen knife. Yes. Okay. Wow, that's another first where you can eat your tumbaani with your knife. That's here in the Upper East region. But I love that. Okay, so Auntie Messi has already started.
Enjoying it.
I noticed you didn't put any salt in the Tumbaani or in the stew,
yeah.
In the guinea fowl stew,
yeah.
And yet there's enough salt in the stew because of your
Onga
seasoning. This is fabulous. All right, so it's during times like these that I don't want to talk much. Auntie Messi, please say something so that I can keep eating.
I'm enjoying the meal, the gaari. It tastes so nice.
Mm-hmm. But you know what we use for the sauce, right?
Yes.
Uh-huh. What do we use?
Onga.
Of course she knows. Oh my goodness. Now I just want to, you know, get out of here and actually finish my food. So Auntie Lamisi, thank you so much. Auntie Lamisi is a far friend. She's prepared gaari or Tumbaani for us. So it's the Onga Foto from Bolgatanga, capital of the Upper East region of Ghana. Onga Foto brought to you by Onga. Mama's helping hand.
Ilele.
Ilele.
Onga. Ilele.